That's only because of percentage, because last night in the American, South Florida blitzed Cincinnati 6-2, while Central Florida edged Memphis and Tennessee 2-1. So what that does is give UCF temporarily the points in first place points lead at 13. UConn has 11 points with the 3 points per win and 1 point for a tie, 3-0-2. So for now, UCF with more points than UConn at 13. South Florida with their win over Cincinnati ties UConn in points at 11. UConn with the game in hand, though. Bulls have a record of 3-1-2 in league play. SMU lurking right there. They have designs on being the number one seed and hosting. And the Mustangs are 3-1-1 compared to UConn's 3-0-2. Huskies the only undefeated team in the league. This is the second to last conference game of the year. UConn will wrap it up at Tulsa on Friday night. Tulsa's having a dismal year. They are now 1-5 in league play after losing to Temple last night, 1-0. Six teams make it. The first two teams get byes. And then it is, of course, highly hoped for that UConn will get more than just today as a finale at Moroni Stadium, as they could be playing in the conference semis and championship game at home. And then if they do run the table, they'd be a pretty good bet to get a home field. Although the number 16 RPI might require some upsets ahead of them in order to guarantee it a home field, but there might be sentimentality, and then there'll be the almighty buck too. UConn brings in the fans, number one in the country, and also they can charge for admissions. So that's one of the legacies of this field over the last five decades, is sometimes when everything else is even, UConn gets the home field in postseason play just because there is revenue involved. SMU will not be a light touch. They came into the season preseason national number 21, but they got out of the gate slowly. They lost in overtime to Providence. They dropped a game to Denver 1-0. They had a tie against St. Louis. They really don't have what we'd call a true quality win so far. They tied South Florida. They lost at Central Florida 2-0. They're coming off a 3-1 win over Cincinnati, and they're riding a four-game unbeaten streak for head coach Kevin Hudson. They are led by Emil Quasho with 5 goals and 6 assists. Akeen Shackelford out of Jamaica has 5 goals. Mustangs outscoring their opponents 21-12. And their goalie has the lowest goals against average in the league. Grant Makela, playing in his 13th game, has allowed just 10 goals, 5 shutouts, and 39 saves. His counterpart in the nets for the Huskies will be Austin Avisa, playing in his 13th game today. 11 goals allowed, 0.87 goals against average with 5 shutouts and just 28 saves. Thanks to Courtney and Paulo with the WHUS sports staff for making this possible. I'm John Tewitt. Glad to have you listening along on 91.7 and on WHUS.org. We really got a saturated field over the last 24 hours, but they brought in the heavy-duty choppers that hovered above the field for about 25 minutes, about an hour ago, and tried to dry out the field. And so, yeah, it's going to be a little bit soggy, but not too bad. They're even having some maintenance folks fill in some of the patches and divots right now, trying to make sure that we have as ideal a playing situation as we can possibly have. UConn starting 11, Avisa in the goal, joined by Jacob Hauser. Ramsey's been dominant in the back and has probably locked up Defensive Player of the Year in the conference honors. Deion Harris has been a spark plug. The Penn State transfer has 4 goals and 5 assists. Dylan Greenberg, outside back, one of the seniors honored in ceremonies just minutes ago. Freshman from Germany, Felix Metzler. Freshman from Senegal, Ibrahima Diop. Josh Burnett. Munir Saleh, the back. Blazen Gog, 5'11", lanky player out of France, and Robin Lappert in back. And that leaves just one player, and that is Abdu Baki Jam, 6-foot senior, out of Senegal. 12 goals and 6 assists, and in recent games, he has pulled out the dramatics, getting worldwide attention on the web with the highlights of his 40-yard-plus bombs. One sailing in to get the victory over Temple, and then his kick over the goalie's head from maybe even deeper than that. It bounced behind the Vermont goalie with less than a minute to go. Bounced off the crossbar, carried off the goalie again, and it was picked up loose by Harris, who rifled it into the open net for an incredible, freaky ending. And Connecticut defeated both Temple and Vermont. Catamounts 3-2 and Temple 2-1. And UConn undefeated at home, 9-0-1. Only blemish was a 2-2 tie against South Florida. Both teams are coming out to be introduced this afternoon. The senior ceremony is keeping things a little bit on the delayed side to get this underway. Quasho leading the way for the Mustangs, 5 goals and 6 assists. Shackelford with 5 goals. Munjoma has 2 goals and 4 assists. And the preseason conference player of the year, Gary McLaughlin, has not had that spectacular a season, just 3 goals and 2 assists. UConn has had a good rivalry with SMU. Last year was a victory for SMU on their senior night as they clinched the regular season championship. One nothing Mustangs a year ago. McLaughlin scored in the 78th minute. But UConn leads the all-time series with SMU. 6 wins, 3 losses, and 1 tie. So again, looking at the standings, it's Central Florida now with 13 points. UConn and South Florida tied at 11 points. SMU has 10 points. Memphis taking the loss to Central Florida 2-1 last night at 7 points. Temple, Tulsa, and Cincinnati bringing up the rear. One of those teams will be one of the 6 teams that make it. 2 top seeds get a bye. So Connecticut, even though they are now trailing UCF by 2 points, they've got today's game in hand, plus the game Friday in Tulsa, Oklahoma, against the 1-5 Golden Hurricane. Ray Reed, in his 22nd season, has been able to avoid the late season tailspin that kept them out of the tournament the last 2 years. A year ago, UConn sailing along, and wheels came off after blowing a 2-0 lead at Boston College. Connecticut, coming down the stretch, really had a rough time of it and ended up dropping games, getting the game that eliminated them from the tournament in the conference tournament against UCF.
A defender, senior captain from Seattle, Washington, number 3, Jacob Hauser.
Open up the window here. We'll brave the elements. It's a little bit on the plus 3 side, but the wind isn't too bad. Not your typical crowd for the rescheduled game, but there'll be several thousand people here for the final game of the regular season anyway here at venerable Moroney Stadium as UConn 80s alum Tony Rizza putting in the big bucks, millions, kick-starting the effort to replace this facility.
A junior from Milton, Ontario, Canada, number 5, Deion Harris.
Referee today will be Cassio Ribeiro. He and his two linesmen and the 4th official are standing clad in orange in between the two teams lined up. SMU will be in all black. Starting keeper Makela will be in red, jogging in place. UConn accompanied in their lineup by 3 youth players. So again, it's Aviza, Hauser, Ramsey, Harris, Greenberg, Metzler, Joe, Baki, John, Burnett, Saleh, Engog, and Lapper.
Number 23.
People still filing in here on this cloudy afternoon. The lights are on. And if you're just joining us, yeah, they were drying out the field with two choppers for 20 minutes, about 45 minutes to an hour ago. We're going to have ourselves a live national anthem, so let's join that now.
We ask that you please rise and remove your hats as we now honor America and those defending our freedom with the singing of our national anthem. Performing the anthem this afternoon, please welcome Paige Drury.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming.
Soccer time in stores, and seems somewhat poetic that UConn will play their final regular season home game at the old Maroney Stadium on a Sunday afternoon after so many soccer Sundays over the years. In the 70s, they play preliminary games on Saturday mornings here before football games. Then Joe Maroney established soccer Sundays, 1 o'clock, became event watching throughout the state. And this is UConn's first day game of the season here at Maroney Stadium, caused by the torrential rain yesterday. Anybody that sat it out at Rentschler Stadium yesterday for the football game against UMass knows exactly what I'm talking about. A good decision to delay it, although there were some gamesmanships and negotiations that had to take place with SMU before all parties agreed to play this one this afternoon at noon. A lot at stake. Both these teams want to host conference tournament games. And UConn, undefeated at home this season, wants to stay that way. They are 9-0-1 at home, riding a 10-game unbeaten streak with an overall record of 10-2-2. 3-0-2 in the league. That's good for first place, playing in their 15th match, second to last match of the regular season. One last huddle. Saleh joins the UConn starting 11, and Deion Harris, who pulverized that loose ball in for the game winner with 37 seconds to go against Vermont, the last to join the UConn huddle. Ray Reed saying this is the toughest team in his 22 years at UConn in terms of their resilience. While conceding, UConn's been playing with fire, allowing goals and also allowing, having to make rallies. But UConn has been resilient, and they have been determined, and they have not let season slip away at all as they have the momentum heading into the second to last match of the regular season against the Mustangs from Dallas, Texas. UConn in the home white, blue numerals will have the opening kickoff. They'll be attacking the goal to our left, the north goal, closest to Shankman Training Center and Gamble. They'll be defending the rink end goal. Austin Avila has those duties. underway. Long ball by Greenberg, aimed at Burnett, bouncing free. Mustang defender Thomas Haney is a freshman from Houston, and he is wearing what looks to be a rugby helmet, but really kind of goofy looking. It's white on the straps. Then a goalie earlier this year at Moroni that had that look, almost like rugby, but probably a concussion issue there. Rolling ball, we have our first slippage. See if UConn can take advantage. Goes right wing, Saleh looking for Harris. It's gonna be a divot day. You can see him start to pop up as the soft ground, despite the helicopters drying it out for the game. They're gonna chop and slice up this field, I'm afraid. SMU bench, another slippage. Yeah, it's definitely soft here in the early going as Metzler slipped, dug it up. Off the throw-in, Greenberg gets it back from Metzler. Now he's gonna reverse it into the backfield to his right. And it goes over to Hauser Ramsey from Seattle. Back to the UConn bench, 70 yards out. Here's Greenberg. No one picks him up, so he carries it. Pass blocked, intended for Baki Jam. Hops back to Metzler. Switch of field to the far sideline. Saleh, he's got Harris on his right. Continues to move. Slide tackle trying to take it off his foot by Shackelford, the 6-foot Jamaican. Second leading scorer with 5 goals. Out of bounds, UConn throw. Pitch in for Harris. Back to Saleh. Can he do anything with it? Tried to make a move down to the right corner. Tapped out of bounds. UConn throw. UConn in white going to the goal to our right. Thrown toward the end line. Harris with a cross looking for Baki Jam. Sitting free at the 6 and rejected back out of the danger zone by the Mustangs. UConn trying to keep the pressure up. We are in the 3rd minute. Home finale of the regular season. Engog kind of lollygagging after it. And Quasho, who's their key star, senior from Orem, Utah. 5 goals and 6 assists. Gave him a little shove, but got away with it. UConn back at it. Cross looking for Baki Jam. Man with a rugby hat, Thomas Haney, got on his knees and headed it out. Nice job by Engog to block the release pass out of the defensive third, and UConn continues to have the better of play here in the opening minutes. Greenberg, deflected shot. It's going to bounce once and easily into the hands of the keeper. 6'4" junior Grant Makela has the best goals against average in the league. Under one, 0.80. 5 shutouts, 39 saves. He's given up just 10 goals. This is his 13th game. If the wind is a big factor, it's that UConn's back here in the first 45 minutes, and I don't think that was really the reason why Makela decided to make a short distribution rather than punt it out of there from left to right. SMU yet to really penetrate into UConn's defensive third down near the rink. They're content to pass it around in the backfield right now. Center back Philip Ponder out of Denton, Texas. That's where the Mean Green North Texas State play. Over the midfield line, it's to Hilt. Haney dropping it back. UConn with all 11 defending. But SMU turns it back over at the midfield line as Harris tries to go right wing, did not communicate with Saleh, and it goes out of bounds about midway through the SMU defensive half. Good start for UConn. Expect both teams to play conservatively, especially when they get used to the soggy and soft turf conditions. 4.5 gone by, no score. Kickoff temperature, 46 degrees here in Stores. Long ball down the left wing as SMU finally gets the ball into UConn's penalty area, headed out by Lapper. UConn looks focused, and so far they've had SMU on their heels. Foul on the Mustangs. UConn puts it into play too quickly for the liking of our official Cassio Ribeiro. And it'll be spotted down about 20 yards shy of midfield. UConn off to slow it down, put it in play for Engog, finds Greenberg unmarked near the UConn bench. 10-yard pass, trades it with Jop Ibrahima, the Senegalese successor, perhaps, to Baki Jam a year from now. Similar slender build. Harris making a run. Now sends it over to Jop. He's got Greenberg overlapping on his left, but he continues to possess. Jop moving it to his right foot. Deflected ball. Hops after it. Stays with it. Moving from left to right. Now finds Saleh. Making his move. Gets to the edge of the box. Back into the corner. Sizing it up for the cross. It's in toward goalmouth. Headed away. Back outside. Metzler shoots and bangs it way high and out of the stadium. And wide right and upstairs by a good 10 to 15 feet for a goal kick. 6 minutes gone by. UConn SMU. So much at stake. UConn in first place percentage-wise in the league at 3-0-2. SMU 3-1-1. Mustangs 7-4-2 overall. Goal kick by Makela. Bounding free. And now Burnett. Burnett looked like he had been leapfrogged by Haney. He's got the rugby style beanie on. But the call goes against Burnett, surprisingly. No score. UConn with a 2-0 shot advantage early. Approaching 7 minutes gone by. Haney again with the ball, freshman from Houston. To Strake Jesuit College Prep School. And although it's natural to think of Texas, particularly the Dallas area, as football central, they do have terrific youth soccer in Texas. And on top of that, SMU being the private school, they often get first dibs on the top prep talent from soccer schools around the Dallas area. But they do recruit around the southeast. They've got Shackelford from Jamaica. And here comes Jope for UConn, pass the SMU bench. Rolls one into the center of the field, about 45 yards out for Engog. And now it's Burnett. Two big goals against BC. He's only two this year. Rolls it back, and Lappert has to bail him out by hustling after it at the inside of the circle. Hauser Ramsey for Greenberg. Of all UConn's backs, except for on set plays like corner kicks or direct kicks, it's Greenberg is most aggressive. But as the season has progressed, Saleh, who has the ball now in the right outside back position, gets involved in the offense. Of course, you got Hauser Ramsey and Lappert. There have been rocks back there for most of the season, although the Huskies have been giving up more goals lately. Two against BC, one to Temple, and two to Vermont. Nevertheless, they've still done a good job allowing only 15 goals all year. This is 15th match of the year. But the trend somewhat alarming. Connecticut has been clutch. They picked up seven wins when the game-winning goal came after the 75th minute. No score, 9 minutes gone by. Initial indications looking good. UConn been able to keep SMU from getting anything going. Haney now for SMU, going down the right wing. Hooks up with Munjoma out of McKinley, Texas. Aimless ball deflects toward the end line. Chased down by Greenberg, and no one within 20 yards. Finds Hauser Ramsey. UConn at 10-2-2, riding a 10-game unbeaten streak. Baki Jam, Haney all over him. Unloads on the pass for Engog. Engog picking up a head of steam, passes midfield. Dribbling on a diagonal toward the right sideline as he views it. Far side as we view it. UConn and White going to the goal to our left. No score, almost 10 minutes gone by in this 90-minute match. Mustangs are 2-1-1 away from their Dallas campus. Nice give and go with Greenberg, but plays it back to Metzler at the midfield circle. Saleh, 10-yard pass on his left for Ngog, and UConn moving it well, but right now limited to passes in the midfield third. Greenberg short tap for Burnett. Burnett, one of UConn's best at possessing under duress, but he gets banged up a lot. This time he takes a spin and ends up holding his lower back. He hits the deck as often as anybody, probably more often than anybody, and lost at, in between the benches by SMU's Munjoma. Throw-in coming up for Greenberg. Short little toss to Burnett. Back to Dillon. Fakes the long ball into the corner. And now has to reverse it 20 yards back to Jacob Hauser-Ramsey. Robin Lappert. Two players from France in the UConn lineup. And Lappert won a national championship at Charleston Division II last year. Dumps it into the right corner. It's rolling toward the end line. And over the end line for a goal kick with 11:13 elapsed. Spotted down the six by Grant Makela. And again, he eschews the punt and will just distribute on his left. Build it up slowly. UConn has been playing SMU since before the American days. First games I ever did, 1983. I ended up having to do the game out of a phone booth. 99 degree heat. And UConn, this is like a good UConn team with Matt Addington, Joe Traeger, and that gang. And UConn fell behind 4-0. Ended up losing 4-2. They got their revenge back here in stores around 84. Bobby Joe Esposito and that crew of the Mustangs. And SMU, although UConn beat them in the final four, has done well over the years. They have led the series 6 wins, just 3 losses, and 1 tie. One of those wins for SMU last year on their senior day, 1-0. Goal by McLaughlin in the 78th minute. Foul going against the Mustangs, Knute. It's not Newt like Newt Rockne, it's K-N-U-T, Ollander. Switch it over to Saleh. UConn's had about 70% of the possession, and the ball has been UConn's half, probably, at least 80% of the time. Kind of a ticky-tack foul called on SMU in between the benches as McLaughlin got more votes than Baki John for preseason player of the year, but his numbers not that spectacular. 3 goals, 2 assists. Bounding ball toward the top of the 18. Abdu Baki Jam taking on Haney, goes to the left foot. Slide tackle over the end line. Corner kick UConn, their first and first of the match. Comes at 13 and a half gone by. He'll go short. Short kick over to Greenberg. Lefty cross going toward the 6. Headed back out. Outside for Saleh. He'll have to get past one player. Cuts back to his right, but it'll be recovered by Warrington. Freshman, 6-footer. Tough contact between Lappert and a midfielder, just shy of the stick. Last touch by Lappert. I'm not too thrilled about that call. Here's Robin. Pretty dangerous with Baki John starting on the left border of the box. And the follow-up after the short corner kick. Greenberg able to get one in. Went out to the perimeter about 22 yards out, and Saleh had that one man to beat, but as he moved it to his right, just got a little too far away from him. This could easily be a 1-0 game. It could also be a 3-2 game. Never can tell. See how it unfolds. Conservative start. SMU certainly on the conservative side. They have not been pushing players forward. Again, I think the soggy turf, something to do with getting a grip and getting a feel for just how this game's going to play under these conditions. Sent toward the top, skimming header wide left. Best chance by a mile for SMU, but also missed by a mile by McLaughlin. Junior out of Oklahoma City. Ran up to meet the cross about a dozen yards out. Tried to go lower left-hand corner, but shanked it off his forehead way wide toward the scoreboard end. It'll be spotted at the six by Austin Avisa. 11 goals allowed. This is his 13th match. Only 28 saves, which is a way of saying UConn has done a good job defensively of keeping him out of trouble. Has not given up very many soft goals at all. Foul UConn, 45 yards out. Visa's goal against average, 0.87. Second in the league, only to Makela of SMU, 0.80. So yeah, 1-0, even 0-0, as UConn had to settle for a 0-0 score against Central Florida in Orlando in the heat, would not be a surprising result. But that would not be great for UConn because they'd find themselves out of the number one seeding heading down to the final game Friday night in Tulsa. UCF edging Memphis in Tennessee 2-1 last night. South Florida blitzed Cincinnati 6-2. Off the free kick 40 yards out, SMU back to the left side. He tried to get it into the foot of Maples. Has to drag it into the scoreboard corner, really being pestered defensively by Hauser Ramsey. Gets a pass off, back toward the end line. Fake. And Gog, right, make a joke with a block, resulting in a 22-yard shot. Left footer wide left. Goal kick. Effort taken by Noah Hilt, 5'11 midfielder out of Centennial, Colorado. About 1,500 to 2,000 people here for this rescheduled game. Not bad considering. No time to make the plans. And of course, there's some Red Sox fans that are still recovering from sleep deprivation today. I'm one of them. 2-2. SMU has, after being kind of pinned back most of the first 7 to 8 minutes, has started to get a little more comfortable and controlling possession. They're in the road black. Haney, guy with the rugby helmet, played back into the circle to his left for Ponder. Back outside. Pretty much everybody on UConn in a defensive posture except for Baki Jam wandering around in the circle. Haney's going to make a back pass. Maples, little floater towards Saleh defending, heads it out of bounds near the concession stand, the trailer, not the wooden concession stand, which is abutted on the end line. We're going to have a throw in here for SMU, 0-0. Here's going to be Lane Warrington, freshman out of Lawton, Oklahoma. Floats it in toward the six. Good throw. Popped up in the air and out of the danger zone. Baki Jam heading it to the left side. Oh, almost hooked up with Engog, who might have been off to the races from 70 yards out. But the header by Baki Jam was just a little off the mark. So you're going to try to build it up out of the back from right to left. Metzler spiked in the shoulder, ankle. Quick foul. Put it in play to Greenberg. And now Baki Jam. Shielding the ball, curling his leg around the midsection of Caleb Smith of SMU, wins the ball away. 19 minutes gone by, no score. Final regular season game at the current Moroni Stadium. UConn trying to stay undefeated at home and complete the regular season. Win would give them a 10-0-1 record at home here in Stores. Thrown at the UConn bench. Now it might even be a foul. No, it will be a throw. SMU taking it. Smith looking to switch directions. Plays it out toward the midfield line for Maples. Carries it. 15-yard run. About 40 yards out. Plays it into the box. A chance here, and a shot is partially blocked. Greenberg to the rescue at the last instant to block an opportunity from 10 yards out for McLaughlin. Ricocheted wildly off of Greenberg, who denied the initial shot, and it'll be a corner kick. SMU thinking about going short. They will go short. Short little tap. Smith walking the tightrope. Brings it back outside. Loose. Engog. His attempt to clear is blocked. Another great block by UConn's Hauser Ramsey. UConn really put under pressure here for the first sustained time this year in this scoreless match. Give and go. Hauser Ramsey playing it back toward the end line. Tries to get it out on a goal kick, but instead deflected cross toward the 18. Headed away. And a foul on SMU. And incredulous is the Jamaican Akian Shackelford, second leading scorer. Probably should have been a no call. Two guys just vying for the ball. UConn had the edge anyway. In terms of getting to it. So Huskies surviving. Nice little flurry of 2 minutes of pressure by SMU. We spotted a point of the foul on Shackelford by Aviza, who's in a hurry. In fact, he goes back and gets a little sip from the water bottle. 21st minute, no score. SMU now out shooting UConn 3-2. Spotted about 4 yards outside of the 18. Mustangs 3-1-1 in the league. UConn 3-0-2. Major import of home field advantage and seedings in the conference tournament coming up. SMU certainly in worse shape in terms of an at-large bid than UConn is, but UConn should be trying to finish this up in a way that does not leave it in the hands of a committee. So as UConn had dominated the first 8 to 10 minutes, SMU now with about 5 minutes of good pressure. Greenberg had to block a shot from about 10 yards out that looked like it was big trouble for Aviza. Throw in by Warrington, headed out of the box by Greenberg, popped up in the air. It'll be settled by Harris, running to his right, but great job stripped by Quasho, their star player. Back out to the midfield zone, following Mujoma, controlling for SMU. Leaves it out on the clothesline. Jope almost was able to steal it and set up 3-on-3. Warrington back pass from the scorer's table. Token pressure by Baki John, who's saying, where's my teammates? Need more pressure up front. UConn doesn't have any numbers, but they force a back pass to the keeper, Makela. Harris got pushed out of the way as he pursued the ball by Maples. No call. Almost midway through the first half, no score. 22-20 elapsed. 2 45-minute halves. Regular season format is if we get tie game after 90 minutes. 10 minutes in each direction, both 10-minute overtimes are golden goal, sudden death, but no penalty kicks. So a maximum of 110 minutes. Boy, Saleh just got pushed out of the way at the stick and no whistle. Bounding ball, forcing Aviza off his line. Makes the grab, or rolls it out with the left hand bowling style. Chance for UConn to counterattack with Metzler finding Greenberg. Greenberg trying to find Baki Jam. Pass a little bit off the mark and just rifled back downfield from left to right by Haney of the Mustangs. Burnett for UConn finds Blaze Engog, sends it along after a second touch for Saleh. Back to Blaze, straddling the midfield line. UConn and White going from right to left. Burnett finds Greenberg. Left wing, pass goes to Jope. Freshman cutting back to his right, left it out too far in front of him, and Smith was able to dispossess. Nice chest trap in midfield by Metzler. Little lefty diagonal feed for Engog in the circle. And now Robin Lappert being pursued around by Quasho, their star forward. 5'11 out of Utah. And I'll confess, not too many Utah players have come up on the radar here over 50 years at Moroni Stadium. Nice footwork goes to Greenberg. Metzler leaving it outside of the box, and Harris keeping the play alive by feeding it back outside. The right wing, Saleh. Looking for the give and go with Bakijan. Broken up. Back out to the left flank. And rejected back over the midfield line. And UConn continuing now. And it's now the Huskies starting to control the flow of play. Jope, Metzler. Nice footwork. Keep it away from effort to pick his pocket by McLaughlin at midfield. Blaze Engog. Nice little floating chip over toward the SMU bench, about 20 yards in bounds. Greenberg with the trap. Now Burnett taps it over to Greenberg. Stays on his feet. He's in the left corner. Plays toward the 18. Burnett's idea was to send it for Harris. Going loose. Engog swings, but comes up empty from about 22 yards out. Rejected back outside. UConn finding their rhythm again. In a scoreless match, we're in the 26th minute. Crossing pass goes off a foot, but stops short of two players awaiting for UConn, Burnett and Harris. Huskies regrouping. After a lot of divots the first 3 or 4 minutes, Soggy Field hasn't been very much of a factor. We had choppers trying to dry things out before the game. Certainly no puddles or anything. Played into the box, a push from behind by Bakijan. And definitely the right call as he knocked down the defender, Philip Ponder. He'll be spotted down inside the 18, midway through. And Grant Makela, best goals against average in the league, getting serenaded by the Railbirds behind him. He's been distributing short, but he's going to kick this one out. But not much of a foot, not even to midfield. But it rattles off a UConn player, Burnett. And now they're going to go direct style all the way back to the UConn 18, popped up out of the attacking zone. Trying to settle is Caleb Smith. Another blooper ball. Settling is Joke. Pressured from behind by Warrington of SMU. Back up to midfield, and UConn with numbers. Bakijan avoids one man, plays it right side for Harris. Dayon with the ball. He's 25 yards out. Gets to the 18. Shot blocked. Trying to recover the rebound. Goes back outside for Saleh. Saleh chipping for Metzler. Chest trap. Spins. Shoots. Off the post. Follow up. Saved. Oh, goodness. What an opportunity for UConn. Metzler tried to sneak it inside the right post. Ricochets off the right post. The follow up shot. Just an opportunistic look what I found. Body saved by the keeper, Makela. And it's a corner kick coming up for Greenberg. It remains 0-0. Now UConn out shooting SMU 5-3. Best chance easily of the day for either team. Greenberg, lefty in, swinger toward the six. Headed away by the man with a rugby hat, Haney. Presumably because of concussion prior in the season, but that's an assumption. All the way back, UConn has to regroup. So Metzler, in the 27th minute, kissing the right post. And great play by Makela. Fortuitous positioning. Denying the follow-up by Harris. Haney's going to kick one, but miss kicks it. It's going to go on two hops right into the red basket of UConn's keeper, Austin Avisa, 6'3" out of Medway, Mass. Started his career at Syracuse. Watched as Scott Levine got all the minutes in his senior year last year. Won the competition after trading back and forth in the exhibition season and even out in Indiana late August, early September, and won the job over Gianluca Catalano, freshman out of Ontario. See if UConn can keep the pressure up. Harris in the right corner, playing it back out onto the sidelines for Munir Saleh. Saleh knocks it off a leg, last touch by SMU. And it looks like UConn's gonna go to the bench for the first time. It'll be redshirt freshman, 5'9", Cole Venner from Burlington, Vermont. He's all fired up for the game against the Catamounts. Venner, one goal and two assists for 4 points on the year. four shots on goal, eight total shots. The defender, Thomas Haney, picking himself up. Little spot down on six for the goal kick for Grant Makela. Dressed in red, his teammates all black. Generally, SMU has blue and red motif, but they like old E.O. Smith Panther soccer uniforms, the all black, which generally doesn't go. A lot of referees wear all black. There's a shot from way downtown and 30 yards wide left, taken by Shackelford.
Goal kick, UConn.
Those E.O. Smith teams that featured a lot of the players that were on the 81 National Championship team, Maroney brothers,
replacing number two,
Brubacher, Lyman, Maisley in that group. Even before that, Tom Nevers, they come in like the Oakland Raiders, all black, with the Old English S. They stopped them from staying with that uniform because too many high school officials had the same black outfit. Today's referee, Cassio Ribeiro, has got the Hunter's orange on, so SMU with the black with white trim. Played in toward the right wing, SMU applauding, but it was not touched last by UConn. It's Quasho trying to get involved in it. Quasho, he's tough, leading scorer with five goals and six assists. Two game-winning goals. Mustangs coming off a 3-1 win over Cincinnati. Part of a log jam at the top of the league, caused by last night's results. South Florida over Cincinnati 6-2. UCF over Memphis 2-1. So UCF now with 13 total points, going by 3 points for a win. Oh, better looking for a steal. 3 points for a win, 1 point for a tie. So as we stand with UConn with today's game in hand, Central Florida with 13 points, UConn and USF both with 13, SMU with 10. So a lot can change today and Friday, the final day of the regular season. UConn will be at Tulsa. Tulsa's been struggling, 1-5, and they lost to Temple last night, 1-0. Burnett tripped up. He was about 8 yards outside of the box. It wasn't a PK trip, but no call. Ray Reed keeps his arms folded in typical pose, not vocal about that trip that could have given UConn a set piece from strikeable range. From the 33rd minute, first half, 5-3 shot advantage, no score. UConn tries to wrap up the regular season undefeated at home and keep their momentum going for possible postseason home games. Otherwise, this potentially could be final game at Maroney Stadium as we know it before it gets rebuilt for 2020 season. Missed kick there, forcing Saleh to turn himself into a pretzel. Beautiful save on the far side. Missed kick. Lappert back to Munir. Collapsing on him is Quasio, but only a token effort. Aimless ball easily stolen away by Ponder in the backfield for the Mustangs. We're in the 34th minute, no score. Closest call, Metzler of UConn from 19 yards out. Lefty that rattled off the right post. Follow up from point blank range by Harris was stuffed on a body block, creating a corner kick. Greenberg had to make a stop from about 10 yards out for SMU's best bid. Hockey John, clever little ball down the left wing and leaves open space. Green Acres down the left wing comes Venner. Venner gets into the box, angling to his right, trying to get a better centering position. Plays it back outside for Engog. Didn't go for the jugular there. Harris, right wing, cross easily stopped by The defender, Maples, calmly delivers to a teammate, and SMU bringing it out from left to right out of their defensive third. 0-0. Thanks to Paulo coming in today, and like a World Series reliever on the spot coming in today and helping us out after the game was rescheduled on short notice. And our regularly scheduled programming too. We appreciate the flexibility to allow us to bring you this action. It was supposed to be on the American television network, streaming by the conference, but they bailed on that. Mustang coach Kevin Hudson's going to make a substitution move as Wyatt Priest, 6-foot freshman out of Coppell, Texas, reports to the scorer's table. Priest yet to score this year. 36 minute, no score. UConn coming off two spectacular wins, knocking off Temple 2-1. Well, just over 2 minutes to go from way downtown by Bakijam, and then Bakijam, who has the ball right now, helping knock off Vermont. Angle to the left, cuts back to his right, tapped out of bounds. Goal Patrol says UConn corner kick. They're right. It'll be a UConn corner kick with 36 minutes elapsed here in first half play. Pretty clever play as Bakijam is at such a sharp angle, looking to his right toward goal, that it was only good thing he could do, really, was to try to either dribble it back out and increase his angle or knock it off a leg for the corner kick. They went short on the first corner kick. Short kick to Greenberg, ended up getting a good cross off. He could go short to Burnett if he chooses to. Keeper 6'4", so being in the air isn't necessarily the right strategy. It is a short tap. Back to Bakijam. And the flag goes up. Offside position for UConn, so wasted opportunity there for Connecticut with 36-36 elapsed in the first half. 2:45 and a half. The official, Ribeiro, is forcing SMU to go back and try it again. It wasn't a goal kick at the six. Instead, it was an offside, so they're going to move him way into the corner. And leaves the goal wide open. And he hasn't been kicking him past midfield. So going back and trying to cover the goal is Maples, the defender. He'll take it from deep in the corner. Left footer, backspin, but this is a good effort. Sailing past midfield from left to right. 50-50 ball. Goes off the leg of McLaughlin, preseason player of the year in the league. Drops it back, and SMU trying to creates a little rhythm as Ollander goes down to the right wing. Mujomba, burst of speed, taken off his leg nicely by Venner. Out of bounds for the Mustang throw. That'll probably allow Wyatt Priest to get into the game.
Reporting into the
looks like he'll be coming in for McLaughlin.
Wyatt Priest, replacing number 7, Garrett McLaughlin.
Fist bump on the way out. Sky getting a little lighter. You can see a little patch of blue sky over on the hill toward McMahon Dorm. Off the throw and fired in toward the end line and knocked out of bounds for a corner kick by Blaze Engog of the Huskies. SMU thinking about going quickly, but it's in the goal corner to closest to the street. In the rink end, near side as we see it.
Be taken by number 10.
Smith could take it short. Quasho, though, probably thinking about going goalward here with over 38 minutes gone by. Halftime. Moving about 7 minutes away. Nope, they're going to go short after all. Back out to Quasho. Lefty cross toward the six. Rattles around. It knocked off an arm, it looked like, but no call. SMU bench there. Off the line comes Aviza. Makes it on the short hop just as the defender was a step late. Attacker was a step late. Aviza, good decision. Come off the line at the right time. He's in the canary yellow shirt today. 13th game, 11 goals allowed. 5 shutouts and a stellar goals against average of 0.87. But outdone by Mustangs keeper, Makela, 0.80 to have the best in the league. No score, but SMU and UConn both showing this could go either way. Huskies have given up yet another corner kick here. Meanwhile, man down, trying to keep it from being a kick. Lying on his back, tough to tell as Lappert and Hauser Ramsey are there and walking away. Trainer coming out to attend to the injury, stopping the clock with 5:27 to go till halftime. Or as they said on NFL Football from London this morning, the interval. Second to last regular season game at Temple. And slowly making his way up is Munir Saleh, who looks like it's his left shoulder, perhaps. Ray Reed's out there. Saleh, right outside back for UConn, is walking. We'll see if he and Ray Reed, so he's gonna have to gut it out, try to play the final 5.5 minutes of the half. Corner kick coming up for SMU. Scoreless match. Down near the scoreboard corner, awaiting the whistle, is Eddie Munjoma out of McKinley, Texas. 2 goals, 4 assists. Ray Reed still on the field. Now I think they're going to have a substitution for Saleh. Let's hope it's not a major shoulder injury. Stinger landed hard trying to defend to keep it from being over the end line. Munjoma. And now it's Nicosi Burgess coming in for UConn. In defensive posture. They should not allow this corner kick until he's in position. Jogging out into the pack. All kinds of jockeying just inside the 18. They're going to go short. Both teams have been doing that. That's high for Hill. Played in. Headed away by Connecticut's Joe. Back outside 40 yards out. Warrington floats it in. Loose round the 6. Popped way up in the air by Lappert, trying to settle is Harris. Beats his man. Now on the dribble, Harris past the UConn bench, gets up to the midfield line, cuts back to his left, shielding the ball, plays it back into the defensive zone, and UConn survives that little storm. And God. And now Harris, weaving his way through. No, it's Burnett toward the end line. Venner, flag goes up, he's offside. Got the cross off.
Offside, UConn.
Goalie Makela is changing low five with Thomas Haney. The offside's trap apparently working there. Pretty good push up field by Connecticut in vain. And it remains 0-0. Huskies out shooting SMU 5-4. Trying to complete an undefeated regular season at home and extend their unbeaten streak overall to 11. SMU would love to be the first to put an L on UConn's home record and be the streak breaker. Entirely capable. A lot of talent on this Dallas ride as Hollander playing it back. Man with the rugby helmet. It really stands out because it's white with the black straps, Thomas Hayden. Aimless trickler back toward UConn's goal, and Aviza scoops it up. Some token resistance by Akian Shackelford out of Savannah Lamar, Jamaica, by way of Indian Hill Junior College. Aviza bangs it downfield as one of his better punts. Headed back toward Metzler at the midfield line. Rattles around a bunch of legs. And God goes down. No whistle. It's a play on. Metzler tried to come up with the interception, but instead, here comes Priest. Came off the bench. Slide tackle by Greenberg to knock it out. Floater back toward Aviza. He's off his line. Makes the grab. Tumbles just inside the 18 for the stop. Not enough oomph on it. Get toward goal, but Aviza in traffic making a good catch. Under 3 minutes to go till halftime, no score. If he's with a sidewinding punt, this one's going to be 70 yards. Could have gotten the assist on that play, but it went off the defense on the long bomb against Vermont. Rocky Johnson consecutive games, diving up long distance from 40-plus yards to create game-winning goals in the clutch. Thrown to the right of the UConn bench for the Mustangs, Lane Warrington. Taking his time. Just over 2 minutes to go in the first half, no score. Warrington disappearing, so the camera crew just to his right. Heaves it in from the near sideline, headed toward the end line on the last touch by SMU, wide right. Now they're going to say it rattled over off a UConn player. Good aggression, forcing it perhaps to just glance off of Endod.
SMU will be taken by number 10, Emil Quaco.
Both teams have been going with the short corner kicks rather than sending it into the pack. A couple of tall goalies here. But this one's going in toward the six, bounding free. Scoots past everyone, chased down toward the far sideline by Hilt. Trying to increase his angle. Floats it in toward the six, headed by Hauser Ramsey, but it goes straight up in the air. Headed out of bounds by SMU for a goal kick. Almost an impossible angle there. For Quaco. You realize one minute to go in the half. The right play would have been to just try to get it back out diagonally in toward the goal mouth area rather than try to shoot from an angle looking straight at the end line. Wide right by about 15 feet. Line drive, goal kick from right to left. Fees' kick was first met by Burnett. Steele, Lappert. 30 seconds to go till halftime, no score. Burgess in for the injured Saleh. Shoulder injury, it would appear, as he left the field minutes ago. Back to midfield circle, and SMU running out of time here with 12 seconds to go. Intermission, they're going to have to go direct toward the scoreboard corner. Lappert chasing it down, shields it, goes over the end line. That would be it for the first 45 minutes. So, hard-fought game, really tough to tell who has the edge. I think Connecticut with the 5-4 edge, that's a pretty accurate reflection of how the balance of play went in the first half. And kick off the right post by Metzler from 21 yards out. UConn's closest call, the rebound went out to Harris, and he was stuffed by the keeper, Makela. Great opportunity here for UConn to finish off the regular season at an undefeated